Hello and welcome to azurewala YouTube channel. We are in part 46 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 81 questions in previous videos. Let's go to question number 82. You have an Azure subscription that contains the hierarchy shown in the following exhibit. So we do have on top level, we do have tenant root group, then we have one management group, and then under the management we do have one subscription, resource group and resource. You create an Azure policy definition, policy one, to which Azure resources can you assign policy one, and which Azure resources can you specify as exclusion. So we have to identify where we can assign the policy and what we can keep in exclusion from the policy one. So we are given the option below. We'll go scroll down and these are our answer area. So where we can assign the policy and what we can exclude from the policy, we need to identify. To test this, we have created a scenario on Azure portal. This is our scenario we created. We do have tenant root group on the top level. Then we do have one management group named MG1. And under the tenant root group, we do have one subscription named subscription1. And under the subscription1, we do have one resource group RG1. And under the RG1, we do have one resource named VNet1. So we can test that where what scope we can define for the policy, or where we can implement on which level. For example, can we implement on the root level, can we implement on management group level, or can we implement the policy on subscription level, resource group level, or the resource level. So this is the one thing we will identify here. Second thing, what we can keep in exclusion, that's what we are going to identify. So for example, can we keep the tenant root management group on the exclusion list? Can we keep the management group on this exclusion list? Can we keep the subscription on the exclusion list? So and so forth. We are in Azure portal now. We'll go to management groups. Under this we can see we do have tenant root group and one subscription and one management group. So we'll go to our root tenant group and we'll go to policy. We'll assign a policy, and under the scope we can select where we would like to implement the policy. So by default the tenant root group is selected here because we went through that. So in the scope, we either can choose the tenant management group, we can choose the management group. In that case, let's say, can we select the management group? Yes, we can select the management group. We under the management group, for example, or tenant management group, we can select the subscription. So I'll quickly select and show. So it's appearing here. Further we can drill it down and we can select the resource group in this case. Let's see. Yes, we can select the resource group as well. So far we have identified that in scope we can either select the tenant root group, we can select the management group, we can select a specific subscription in this case, also we can select the resource group, but we cannot select any resource here because that option is missing. So in the scope we have to keep in mind that up to the resource group we can select. Let's see what we can exclude now. So I will change it to tenant one, and in the exclusion we will select exclusion. Can we select the tenant root group? Yes, we can select, as you can see here, but there is a thing to note, we cannot save it. So when I go here and I see, or I add this one, I tick this and I add select scope, I cannot select the tenant root group. So this is not only the tick, after that it should be able to select as well. So it's not selecting on the tenant root group. When I tick on the management group, I can add this. Yes, I can add this. You can see it here, it's selected. But when I was doing the same with the tenant root group, it was not selecting. So management root group I can select and I can save it, and it displays here. That means not the tenant root group I can select, but management root group I can select. I'll remove this. Let's see on the what else I can select. Let's say I can select subscription and I'll add it, and yes, I can select the subscription as well as a exclusion, in this case policy exclusion. So that is doable. Now under the subscription, can I select the resource group? Yes, I can select the resource group. Let's test it. Yes, I am able to select the resource group as well. So that part is working. Now let's see on the resource itself. So I'll remove this one and select subscription. Under the subscription resource group, under the resource group I can select particular resource and I can add to scope. So I can exclude a particular resource from the policy as well. So on the diagram we can see our policy scope can start from the tenant root management group to any management group, any subscription, and up to the resource group. So this can be our selection of scope while defining the policy. So that's the one, up to the resource group. But at the same time, if we would like to exclude something from the policy, we can exclude the management group, we can exclude the subscription, we can exclude the resource group, and we can exclude the resource. So this will be our range in the exclusion list. Back to our question. So we can see where we can assign the policy to subscription resource group only. Definitely not. We can do it further. Management group 1 and subscription even we can do on the root tenant root group as well. Therefore this is incorrect. Tenant root group, management group and subscription, but resource group is missing here, so that's not correct. Tenant root group, management group and subscription and resource, yes, definitely we can implement a policy up to the resource group level, but we cannot do it for a specific resource. That's why this statement is correct and next one is incorrect, because the resource is included here which we cannot implement a policy on. Next one is, can we exclude the policy one from virtual machine one only? Not only the virtual machine, we can further exclude the things. Resource group 1 and virtual machine only, no, further we can exclude many things. Subscription 1, resource group 1 and VM only, no, that is also not correct. We can exclude management group as well. So a management group 1, subscription 1, resource group 1 and virtual machine, yes, this is the correct. We can exclude these many things. But next one is a tenant root group, management group, subscription, resource group and virtual machine. We cannot exclude the tenant root group, therefore this is incorrect. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell notification icon, and also share with your friends. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.